Hello everyone, welcome to my personal YouTube channel Security Beast, myself Kaustubh Padwan, and today we are going to discuss about ARM. So I am planning to announce this as a course kind of thing. So this will be free of cost, it will be available at my YouTube channel. So in this course we are going to cover about ARM reverse engineering and ARM assembly. Okay, so we have to start from the understanding perspective. What we understand about the ARM. So what is ARM basically? So ARM is nothing but a processor or microcontroller which act as a CPU in most of the devices. Okay, so many people might be wondering what is ARM or why I have to care about ARM and what is the security related stuff doing into the ARM. Okay, so like we have a computer at our home, we have Intel computers, AMD computers. Similarly, in embedded or IoT world, ARM plays a major role. ARM is the chipset for the embedded devices. So all the embedded devices, let's assume that you have a Hikvision CCTV camera or any cameras, like when I say devices, I don't want to make it complex, I have to make it a user friendly video. So once a wise phrase said by Albert Einstein, if you want to master it, you can teach it, and if you can't teach it, that means you don't know about it. Okay, so I'm trying to improve myself day by day. Okay, back to the topic. So every day we were wondering about what is the ARM and what is the MIPS and what that microcontroller do, or how it is relevant to play a security, how the security is relevant to this video, or how the security is related to ARM. So unlike C or C++, this is the common languages for all the platform. We have to code in the Intel mode or the 64-bit mode. Okay, so similarly, knowing the architecture of the device is the most important part. So in ARM case, you have to, the binary which is designed for ARM cannot be run on Intel. Similarly, the Intel binary cannot run on the ARM mode. Okay, because the whole set is different. Like the ARM have RISC, reduce instruction sets computing, and similarly in other ways, like there are two major categories of processor, like RISC and CISC. CISC stands for the complex instruction sets computing, and RISC stands for the reduced instruction set computing. In ARM we have 32 instructions available as now, maybe could be more in some multiple modes. I think in thumb mode there are 16 registers available, 16-bit instructions available, and in ARM mode it's a 32-bit instruction available. Okay, so where ARM processor is get used? Okay, like Apple uses ARM processor in their mobiles. Similarly, when we say boss, you know, it have a Qualcomm Snapdragon. So what is Qualcomm Snapdragon? That processor is also ARM processor. Okay, in your mobile phone, whatever mobile phone you are using, that mobile phone might also have a ARM processor. So ARM is a small processor which runs a wide sets of devices. So if you compare the quantity in the market of the computers, so compared to x86 and 64-bit computers, ARM computers are major in the market. Like, you count the mobile phone in a family, like every mobile phone, every family average have at least 4 Android phones. That 4 Android phone is nothing but an Android computer, an Android operating system based computer, which is having Linux kernel running on that ARM processor. Okay, so everyone uses ARM processor in their day-to-day life. So if you have a CCTV camera, it have ARM processor in it. If you are using Android mobile, it have ARM processor in it. If you are using the iPhone, it have ARM processor in it. So what is ARM? So ARM is not a company who manufactures the processor. ARM is a company who designs the processor, who designs the instruction sets and a blueprint of the processor. And then companies like Broadcom, Huawei, or Huawei, Broadcom, and the leading is the Texas Instruments. These companies manufactures the processor based on the standard or the design made by the ARM company. So ARM is a company, I'm not sure. Also, Mali is the graphic processor for ARM. You might heard of in this mobile you have a Mali processor. So ARM is the main heart of all the mobiles. Okay, so everything is so like almost is, if you are here, then I believe you are aware of the computing, like a basic computing. So every computer contains of RAM. It have a hard disk. It have a motherboard. It have a processor. It have a SMPS. And then outer set like a cabinet, monitor, keyboard, mouse, and blah blah blah, whatever accessories you have. So in embedded devices, what happen is this is all in one package, all in your pocket. So it have a battery. Let's consider. I believe mobile is the most powerful weapon nowadays. So it have everything. And for this our ARM example, mobile is the best thing to understand. So what mobile is? So if you look from the researcher perspective or the computer or hardware engineer perspective, mobile consists of multiple things. One is the motherboard. On that motherboard, there is the same ARM processor. Like many companies manufacture, like for mobile, MediaTek is there, Qualcomm is there, and many more companies are there who manufactures their own processor. Like Samsung manufactures their own processor, Apple A7 manufactures the Apple A7, I don't know what is the recent series. So Apple manufactures their own processor. So these all are ARM processors. So mobile have the motherboard, it have the processor, it have a RAM inside it, a very tiny RAM, it have a storage inside it, okay. And so this all the PC content, and like PC we use SMPS for the power supply, mobile we have a battery supply of 3000 mAh or 6000 mAh, whatever the battery is. On that device, we boot a Linux operating system, right? Like a Linux kernel. On top of it, we run an Android operating system. Okay. So all these devices are the computer itself. It's a mini computers. It have all the characteristics of computers. As just we discussed about the how the desktop and desktop or laptop or mobile have. So it have a whole same system. So let's take one powerful CCTV camera. Or it's just a small camera, right? Like we power it on IP camera and we can see the videos in it. Okay, so how this camera work? That small PCB have a processor, it boots like a other operating system. It have a majorly it have a Linux operating system in embedded devices, or some microcontroller based devices contains RTOS kind of stuff. Okay, let's not go into that. First focus on this, as we have to learn ARM assembly and reverse engineering, we must have an ARM computer with us, right? As I told, in that CCTV itself, it have a hard disk. From that hard disk, we generally it calls a NAND flash, NAND flash, or multiple flash storages available, NAND, SAND, and this flash is the hard disk for them. Also, it contains the RAM. Like you might be wondering that what RAM is doing there, right? But to boot an operating system, the RAM is required. From initial stage of boot bootloader, like we have to create a RAM disk. So RAM is required, right, to boot a computer. So when you power on the CCTV, everything started working. Like it, like in brute process, we say pin number 37 start hitting and processor gets started. So similarly, this board get power on, it get the processor gets started. And then kernel boots after post. So yes, post occurs in these devices too. It occurs a post, and this obviously the operating system gets loaded from the NAND flash, or this have a multiple file system formats, like as I explained in my offensive embedded exploitation video, that what kind of file system we have. Okay, then whole Linux started booting up. Okay, and once the OS is booted, these devices are pre-programmed to do what they want, what they have to do, right? Unlike mobile, like mobile have to do many things, but if you take a small device like a CCTV camera, I'm majorly focused on that only. For an example, it's easy to understand example. CCTVs are like, you know what happened when you start the CCTV? It boots the whole device and it starts the application binary, and that application binary start its work. Like you know, it got a DHCP, it got an IP address, and after getting IP address, it gets into the network, then it starts FFmpeg, and it starts recording from this source. Like, in our future videos of this series, we might be coming up with, like, how to access the camera from our ARM computer. Okay, so kind of many things are there in this series. We are in this ARM series. We are going to do. Okay, so this is kind of a instruction kind of course. This first video is kind of an instruction video. Okay, for our upcoming series for this series which we have started. I am supposed to start this series in January, on the first day, but due to some busy time, I was not able to make it. Okay, so this have hard disk, boots, start, application, binary. So that means it have a computer, it have a shell, right? And when you have to learn the x86 reverse engineering, you must have a x86 binary, you must have a x86 computer, and you must have a tools to disassemble the x86 binary and learn from it. Okay, so I want to give you a few glimpses of ARM. It's not just too much theory, but just a basic thing which I prepare for today, first video. So key points to note it down is ARM is the company which designs the processor, and the companies like Broadcom, TI, Apple, Samsung, they manufacture the processor. ARM is the RISC processor, RISC processor. Okay, oh shit, something wrong happened. So looks like my SSD is not responding properly. Okay, PC rebooted. So nodes have been gone. Let's get it back. Okay, my PC is back. Now I'm zooming. Okay, then endianness can be configured. You might be heard of a big endian, little endian. Okay, address starts from right to left, left to right. So in ARM, endianness can be configured. Also, ARM have at least 32 registers in it. Okay, and we will get into that in next videos. It have 8 privileges mode, like we say the kernel ring, PF ring, and Intel in, we say the rings of processor. It have 8 privilege modes. Okay, ARM processor works in a 2 modes. One is thumb mode and second is ARM mode. Okay, so thumb mode operates in 16-bit wide instruction set, and ARM mode operates in 32-bit wide instruction set. Okay, and the data types which supports in ARM is byte, half word, word and double word. Okay, these 4 are major data types in the ARM. So byte is of 8-bit. Half word is 16-bit, word is a 32, and double word is 64-bit. Okay, also ARM operates in 64-bit. And the registers which are present in ARM is like a 16 general purpose register of 32-bit. Register starts from R0 to R15. R13 used as a stack pointer, R14 used as a link register, and R15 used as a program counter. Okay, these are the major registers available in ARM. And there is one special register called CSPR, Current Program Status Pointer. So we'll look into this later. Okay, for introduction, this will be sufficient on the technical side. We are going to cover more details technical in upcoming videos. Okay, now, as I said, like to reverse engineer the binary into ARM, we must have a computer. Okay. So like you can't just root the CCTV and start using it as a computer. Like I have a plenty of devices of ARM, but I can't open the device and get a shell over it and start coding there, because there are many security checks are there. Like it have a secure boot, so whatever the data you have put, it got restarted, and again you come with a fresh. So you can't use those ARM devices as a computer. We need a computer, right, of ARM processor. Okay, and also other thing is, like, not all the slash partition are read write in the ARM devices. That is a part of security check which we are going to cover in the later videos. Okay, so now to purchase the ARM computer, I had two options. One is the Texas Instrument BeagleBone Blue Black, and the second one is our favorite Raspberry Pi. So Raspberry Pi I preferred, and I went for a Raspberry Pi due to number of reasons. Like Raspberry Pi have multiple interfaces more than BeagleBone. Raspberry Pi is cost efficient. Raspberry Pi can be customized in a wide way. And finally, I ordered my Raspberry Pi from Amazon. So I ordered a Raspberry Pi box from the seller. Where is the seller name? Okay, I think they don't have a seller name in the box. Okay, so it's called a Pi in the box, which we are going to open today. And this is my computer. Yes, here we go. Here it's sold by Discount Bazaar India, and delivered to me. And this is my Pi in the box, Pi Box India. You can order it from Amazon. So actually, there are few sites available which are approved, like Robu.in is the site, Thingbits is the site, which gives you Pi for less cost. Okay, but I ordered the Pi box because it contains everything whatever I needed. So let's open it. What is inside? Yeah, I'm going to open this. Yeah, it's not an unboxing video. It's like the first set of computer which we need for reversing further. I'm trying to act normal, I believe. Yeah. So this is my Pi box. Okay. It have this cute bag, Pi box, string bag it says, a book, critical startup checklist. Okay. And did you break your Pi again? So this is a book of tips and tricks for the Raspberry Pi. It have contained some instruction how to log in and all these things. And this is the micro HDMI to HDMI cable, that was the most needed. This is the LAN cable which I got. And this is the Type C charger, mobile charger, I believe. Okay. Yeah. This is the charger for the Raspberry. And this is the cute little case which was needed for my Raspberry Pi. Okay. So this is the case. And these are the fans I ordered, 6500 RPM fans. And these are a few heatsink chips are there, and the SD card. It's a 32 GB SD card, SanDisk, which is for the operating system. And I don't know what is this. Micro SD USB card reader. Okay, these guys are kind enough to give us a card reader also for flashing the further operating system in this. And this is my Raspberry Pi 4 computer, and I'm super excited to open this. Here we go. And this is our computer. So check out the size of our ARM computer. This is super cute. So it have a RAM. It have everything in just this small. These are GPIO pins which we are going to use it later. And this is the place for the Type C. This is dual HDMI. This is 3.5 volt audio. 4 USB slots, 2 3.0 and 2 2.0, and 1 LAN port. So they suggest that do not touch bare hands to the Pi, because the static can damage the board. Doesn't care about your safety, because This is so cute. So tomorrow, or maybe in the next video, I can't commit. Tomorrow will be in my next video is coming. This is the heat sink. We are going to install. First, we are going to boot this cute pie, and once we have booted this cute pie, we are going to load a black arc in this. So black arc is the pen testing operating system for ARM. So obviously, as name suggests, it is the ARM based operating system designed for the pen testing on the ARM boxes. Okay, so that's all for today. I hope you guys might have learned something beautiful today, something useful today. Okay, and okay, this was the charger. So I believe some people might wanted me to make a video of starting the Pi box. If yes, then let me know in comment. If you know how to boot this up, and if you don't want to know how would I set up this, then that's fine. Okay, we can directly start from the installation of the Black Arc operating system onto our Raspberry Pi. Okay, thank you. Have a great day. Thank you, everyone.